Right, welcome back to another bacon packing video again. Right, what we've got here is all the kit that I've explained, all fully waterproofed, all individually waterproofed. Right, when doing this, okay, you just need to get yourself set up, plenty of light, right, get yourself a brew on and just work through methodically and slowly. Right, what we're going to do now is start to work and prepare the bacon. First thing you're going to need, to get yourself a chair. Right. First thing you want to do, get your bacon, the back of the bacon, over the back of the chair. The bacon flat, so it goes over the back itself. Open up your bacon like so. Up and just sits nice on the chair. That'll give you stable bacon when you're packing. All the things you want to do is all these loops. Right, you need to extend these. Right, so you've got the maximum. Right, so the bacon's open completely, so you've got enough room to pack all your kit. You ain't got much room in these. Once you're happy you've done that, and you've done all your checks and your bacon to make sure everything's serviceable and in working order, you then move on to your rock pouches. Right. Done your checks, make sure everything's fine. What you need to do now is to attach them. Another point, when you've got your rocker pouches on and you've got the frame, as in the yoke on the rocker pouches, make sure all the little straps are pushed up inside, okay, because the last thing you want is all everything hanging out, you're caught in brambles or whatever you're going through, and it gets all pulled away. Right. Another point that I haven't brought onto yet is how to waterproof your stuff. Bin bags, if you've got them. Dry bags are good. However, you ain't got no dry bags, you have to use the old bin bags. I've used them, alright, they're okay. I'll just show you one, alright, how to waterproof one piece of kit. Because basically, guys, I'm going to be here forever. Alright, here are the old classic DPM Gore-Tex bottoms. What you need to do is start laying them off flat, fold them over. What you need to do is just roll. Right. This packing also is quite good for when you go on holiday, you know. When you're packing like suitcases and you can't get anything in. If you do use this method, it helps. Get your bin bag and just clutch it like so. What you're doing then is that you squeeze them as much as you can. You see, yeah? Pull the air out and twist it and then wrap it over like so. Alright, some guys, they call the slack off, alright, but then you're limiting yourself with the bin bag that you got with the piece of kit. Only fit that piece of kit, so we just use one bin bag and then just wrap it round. Okay, the bin bag can be used for other things afterwards. Right, next step, once you've waterproofed all your kit, you've checked your bag and you've applied all the rocker pouches, you're then going to start doing your first set. When we're first set is that you start putting your first waterproof linings into your bergen. Again, if anyone turns around and says these things are waterproof, they need to go back and have a think, because they're not. Basic bin bag, or these thicker bags, you get these in rubble sacks, you get them B&Q or places like that, we'll do any hardware shops, they're alright. Check the bag, make sure there's no holes or rips. Alright, because the last thing you want to do, you've got a hole and rip. Alright, you work with all your kit, you've gone through all that work, and then it doesn't work. Your kit gets compromised, and that's it. All your kit gets wet. Place the bin bag so it fills the hole inside of the bag. And just push it out with your hands, push it down. Making sure the bergen liner never wants to play. Like what you do in your wheelie bin liner, this only wheelie bin. Alright, next step now, so I'm putting the kit in. Got to think about what you're going to use first, like what you think that you're going to need first that comes out your bergen. Alright, no good packing the stuff that you desperately need at the bottom of your bergen, because then you've got to tape it all out to get it out. So spare combat suit or your dry kit, put that at the bottom of your bergen. Now this one comes like Jenga, right? Stack it like so, and build it up and build it up. So one there, like so, and build it up. It should give you a stable bergen, but we'll come to that in a sec.
each kick that goes in, right, making sure that you're pressing down, making sure that the air gets out the bacon and off the kit. Also as well, you've packed your kit yourself, right, so you should know, even with the bin bags on, what kit's what. Alright, the idea is, it's dark, you're in a forestry block or whatever you're doing, airsoft or camping, right, you can go into your bergen by hand and pick out whatever it is that's in there that you know. Again, so you don't have a bergen explosion, you can kit out, you know, what's in there. So not forgetting, inside the pouches, they also need to be waterproofed as well. Right, throw your scram and your desac into your desac and into your rubber pouches as well, so you can get at it quickly. Also, put one fuel canister and your cook ahead and move your food so you've got it all together. Once that's done, what you're going to do, put your bin bag, just crimp it and just fold it over. Right, making sure the bin bag doesn't get caught in the sips, right, because it'll just rip your bag and you can start again. Hence these rubber dry bags are ideal. Next pouch is admin, right? It's bare bits and bobs. What you think is admin that you can get at too, so you're not actually destroying your bergen trying to get that stuff out. What's your preference? Right, I'm not telling you what to do. To be honest, when you go back, when you go into the field and you dig an empty bag in, right, when you've packed it indoors, half the time when you get back outside, you totally rearranged it. Right. But that's the way it is. First aid kit. Can I have a go here or in there? You want to get that, you want it so it's accessible. Just let some of your mates know where it is. So there's no drama. You just keep a couple of water bottles spare in your bag rather than going into the webbing all the time. Push down the side. Wash poles. Right. You're saying to yourself, where's your sleeping bag? On the second. Right. Gore-Tex bivvy bag. Right, first thing you want to do is get your sleeping bag. You checked it. It's clean. To one side. Right, you can, all the different ways you can do it, you can put it in the compression sack, take your chances with it inside, but what I usually do is that I leave it unpacked, right, as it is, so I can just get it straight out. The thing will compress, right, it's not a problem. see, bacon stands up on its own. It's ready to go. Alright, you got a balanced bacon, but guys, this is nothing compared to what other guys carry. I hope you enjoyed me sweating and busting the blood vessel packing that thing. Alright, cheers.